Alrighty. Versus Thrall. Looking for win number three. I'm feeling really confident. I think this deck is actually really good. Really, really good. Trickmeister is a great two. Any master is a fine three, so why not? We'll stick him around. Trickmeister, not really a two drop, but hey, it's got friends, so maybe. Maybe, just maybe. Yeah, I mean, 2 mana, 3-2. It's just so sad to not get full value out of Shrinkmeister. Maybe I can hold out to turn 3 for Impmaster, because it'll just be so much better if I can have Shrinkmasters later. Hopefully this is fine. What's coming down? Spider Tank? Yeah, I mean, I can play Impmaster into Spider Tank. That's fine. It's totally fine. So Spider Tank, not big enough to take down the 1-4, and not much value taking down a 1-1, so that's pretty good.
Something needs tinkering?
Ooh, big stuff happening. Much scary. And I've got nothing! Nothing! Yes. Let's just, I mean, do I play a Shrinkmeister here? Probably. I probably need to run out of Shrinkmeister. Safety Shrink. Do I attack anything once I Shrinkmeister? I mean, I probably need to play this. I think I attack it? Yeah. Yeah, alright, that is what I wanted to do. It's still not great on the board, but hey, it's fine. I got 5, 6, 8. It's all fine. Once we move from the mid-game to the late-game, I'll have it made. Shadow of Death for big stuff. And, yeah, that'd be good. So, I mean, it's a pretty standard... Aside from the missing 2-drop, it's a pretty standard constructed opening. Alright, I would really like my Shadow Word Pains. Can't get there. Well, I guess we'll just play the Yeti and pass. Hope for the best. If I can get upgraded Repair Bot on Yeti, it'd be so good. So it's worth the risk there. I could just play upgraded Repair Bot, and a 5-5 on this board is pretty nice. But it looks like Yeti's gonna stick around. No? Why would you leave a 3-4 if Yeti's sticking around? That doesn't make sense. Just hoping for healing totem. Okay. Well, this is gonna work out quite well then. We're just gonna upgrade. Just a casual 4-9. No big deal. Micro Machine's gonna get big, but as soon as it gets big enough, I'll actually have a target for Shadow and Debt. Hooray. Steal them 4-9s. So what am I worried about? I'm not worried about big things. Flame Tongue Totem? It's pretty good value. Oh, okay. Cold Master, that's pretty bad news. So now although my opponent didn't place it so that, to allow for Conga Lining here. So my opponent is going to draw the extra card off the Stone Claw Totem. And that's unfortunate. But I can now Shadow Word Death my opponent's two guys. So at least I've got that going for me. My opponent draws a card. Shadow Word Death this guy. Shadow Word Death this guy. I'm gonna play this guy and hope that there's not something absolutely massive that's gonna destroy me here. So if a Boulder Fist Ogre comes down, that is really bad for me. Really bad. At least I get to kill the Flame Tongue Totem. But you know what? Mind Control turn is coming up. And, you know, my hand is really good. I just happen to have like half the number of cards my opponent does. Yeah.
The gates are open.
I thought something like that might happen. Yeah, that's pretty unfortunate. So, I mean, I can play Max, and I will play Max, I guess. So I can shrink it down to 6. Alright. Now we just play Max here. Yeah, that's unfortunate. I don't have regrets for killing a 6-2, soon to be 7-2 Micro Machine, but it's still unfortunate. You kinda gotta do what you gotta do. I'm hoping that the rest of my opponent's hand is small stuff. Alright, bye bye. Leaving an 8-1 is so unfortunate.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
Ugh.
Mind if I roll?
At least Force Max is not going to take damage from Lord of the Arena, but it's still so unfortunate. Okay. So we just play Boulder Fist. Boulder Fist, under the circumstances, not as great as it could be. What you gonna do? So, my opponent can... let's see. So it has to be two things. So, Silverhand Knight plus Squire to take down Force Tank, and then I'm still left with Boulder Fist, so I'm still doing okay, actually. And still have this Mind Control. No great mind control targets. Might want to mind control one of these 2/3s now. Which is pretty unfortunate, but you know, you absolutely do what you have to do. Because otherwise I attack 2 and then I take a million. So if I take one of these, then I can kill the Flame Tongue Totem. Yeah, alright. So it's what I gotta do here.
Me smash.
It's not bad for stabilizing, though. So my opponent can send a 4-4, and then I'm only taking 4 down to 11. And I've still got huge guys on the board. So it's not bad. It's not bad. Spending 10 to take a Spirit Wolf is pretty bad, but... and Fire Elemental. Yeah, it's disvalue. So, if my opponent goes face, that's probably better for me in the long run. Unless my opponent's packing damage spells. But I would have expected to see damage spells taking out my minions earlier. So I'm not counting on those. My turn. Alright, damage for me. You probably want to take out Boulder Fist though. Oh wow, no, that's really good value. That's much better. Okay. 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 So I need to shrink this. And I've got enough left over so I can just play bot. And I could Shadow Word. Oh. Oh, I do have a mech. Hello. Oh, that changes everything. And then I can Shadow Word to kill one of these, but I think that's about the same as me healing. Except I use up a card, so I'm just going to heal here. Huh. That was pretty good. So my opponent's only got 4 attack on the board. Well then. Now we're creeping back. We're creeping on back. Huh. I just completely discounted upgraded repair bot. Like, it's never going to come up that it's going to be relevant giving health to a force tank max, but apparently it will be. Definitely built my deck to grind out the long games, and the games are long. Very long. Then take out my 3-2, I'm guessing. So taking down Fire Elemental, healing up my Force Tank is still fun. Okay, it's gonna leave a 2-2 on the board. But hey, I got ooze value. Please, no taunts. Ah, wrecked. Okay. I'm gonna play Twilight Drake first. We absolutely have to Shadow and Pain the totem. Yeah, absolutely. Just enough to swamp ooze. Little bit unfortunate, so Swamp Ooze now gets killed by 2-2, but still okay. Still controlling this board. Blood Mage Thanos not doing much for me at the moment. Might need to just run him out and draw a card, though I'm optimistic that I'm going to draw Holy Nova. Holy Nova would be so good. Although I suppose the extra 1 damage is not a huge draw. So yeah, probably next turn just play Blood Mage Thanos so it can die quickly and I can draw into something better. Oh no! Not Force Tank! Well, down he goes. So I have lived through 2 Fire Elementals. What else we got? Zor! Okay. Rock on. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to send both these guys in. It's pretty sucky. What else am I gonna do? I'm gonna play these 2 guys, heal myself, and I can't race. Trogzor attacks me for 6, and yeah, that's just too risky. Just got a 2-for-1 myself here. Do what you gotta do. And I'm not controlling the board, I got no cards in hand. At least Blood Mage will draw me a card. That's all I got. That's all I got. Okay. Please kill Thanos. Alright. Good stuff. Darkhan Dwarf, not sufficient to actually take out anything of note. Dang. Ooh, Tinker Town, hello. That was lucky. Lucky actually had a mech. Return a friendly minion. Okay. How do I even attack here? So my opponent's gonna have 3, 6, 7. Heal myself. Jeez. Is putting 4 on Coda even good? No. It's not. It's really not. I think I'm just taking out a totem, actually. As sad as it is, I gotta control the board. That's all I've got. And it's gonna be hard, because my opponent's got 4 cards in hand. But I have to try. I have to try. I think I'm happy to see Nerubi Deck. Not happy to see Taunt Totem any day. So I'm just getting hit for 4 here. That's okay.
Feel the power of the
wind speaker. Alright. Sticking another 3. Okay, taking down my guys. Alright. Okay. So my turn, I'm gonna have to send a 4-4 at the... A what? Okay. That's odd. Taking down the 2-1? Really? Alright. This is a good time to draw Force Tank Max, so we're gonna play him and heal. Oh, the clutch Force Tank. Please, Force Tank. Please get there. Just wait for the time rewind on Force Tank for the ultimate values. It's gonna happen. It's quite likely to happen. No taunt is good. No healing is good. Bloodlust, does that kill me? 13, 7, 16. Just one short. Alright, opponent's gonna put me to one. Not what I would have chosen. I think my opponent maybe miscounted. Awkward. Or is there more damage? Okay, just more guys. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna need something. Alright, Thought Steal. Come on. Come on, Thought Steal. Gonna need something. Earth Shock. And I'm at 3. Yeah, that works. In a pinch. Oh no, it doesn't work. It doesn't work, I'm just dead. I go 3. So I can take out a 3-3 and a 3-3. I can Earth Shock Shade of Naxxramas down to a 1-1, but then down to a 2-2, but then I'm taking a 3. So I'm actually exactly dead. Well played. Well played.
Done.
2 many things.
Well played.
Got me there. So the Bloodlust one shot ended up being enough.
I think.
Oh, well, but we fought well. Played well, fought well. Came up this short. Not to worry. Alrighty. Looking for a third victory against a priest. This is sure to be interesting. This could take a while. we're going to keep the Shadow Word Pain, and we can afford to send the rest back. Nemesh Inventor is probably fine in the matchup, but we could probably do better. And I think getting another Shadow Word Pain is probably what I'm looking for. Force Tank Max is going to be good at 8 mana. Not great to have in your hand in the opener. That's okay, we got plenty of business here.
Mind if I roll knee?
Okay, Shadow Word Pain on a Loot Hoarder, not the best value. But you do what you gotta do. Well, it's only 2. It's only 2. I think I might pass. As soon as I can play a 3-3, I can just take out the Loot Hoarder for a little bit better value than Shadow Word Pain. Injured? Oh, here we go. That's the value that we want. Okay. So is there any danger here? The absolute worst, I play Tinkertown Tech and my opponent gives extra health to Northshire Cleric and sends in Loot Hoarder and then heals Northshire Cleric. Yeah, no, that's fine. Velen's Chosen, alright. So, 1-for-1 Velen's Chosen, but then I get to Shadow Word Pain. The Northshire Cleric still just fine. And then we'll just heal here. So at some point I can take care of Loot Hoarder, maybe Earthring Pass, and maybe Holy Nova. There's not really any rush to do so. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. There's some serious Shadow Word Pain value. Alrighty. Doing well. Alright, so we're getting to the point. Might be our Shadow Word death zone. Otherwise, Bomb Orb is pretty sweet.
Special delivery!
Okay. Seems fair. So, do I run out the Bomb Lobber and hope for the best? So, Bomb Lobber hitting the Loot Hoarder is pretty sucky for me. But hitting the 3-3 would be so good. Light Bomb. Interesting. Might just heal and pass. There's only 5 on the board. And, I mean, the beauty of Light Bomb, it's an epic. Who's going to be playing around an epic in Arena? Not a chance. My opponent, Mind Visions, might be getting a Mind Bomb. Let's hope not. How far can we push it? That's the question. There's not a whole lot on the board at the moment, and I can Holy Nova almost all of these. Maybe I'll Holy Nova this turn? Just get my twofers? It's probably fine. Holy Nova heal, that manages the board. Should lull my opponent into a false sense of security here. It looks like it does. So I can just get casual 3-for-1s with a Light Bomb now. Or I could wait until next turn when I can play Light Bomb and then Imp Master. Yeah, we can take a turn here. It's gonna look really, really suspicious to have 6 mana up and not play anything. Really suspicious. Hey, my hand is just all Shadow of Deaths. What can I say? So, the smart play is to just attack and pass, and that's what my opponent does. No surprises there, but we're still going to Light Bomb Imp Master here, I feel. Get my 3-for-1s, have my dude on the board. That's pretty good. So pulling ahead on cards, I've got Shadow of Deaths for anything big, Bomb Lobber for anything small. Looking good. I like this spot. So my opponent did Mind Vision something.
Let me change your mind.
Ooh. Really? That's pretty brutal. Bomb Lobber getting worse all the time. Jeez. Alright, but I can just play Mechanical Yeti here. Upgraded Repair Bot.
Repairs available.
That is unfortunate. Rather unfortunate. Damn. Not to worry, I'm playing big stuff, so the Imp Master is not going to...
The damn
stuff. It's not going to wreck me too hard. But still unfortunate. Down goes the 5-5, but the 4-9 in the clear. So many little things. I'm actually in danger of just dying to this horde of nonsense. Oh, Shadow of Pain. Oh, baby. So I want a Bomb Lob. Maybe I just need to roll the dice on this one.
I wonder.
Yeah. Okay. Alrighty then. I can attack Dark Cultist and hope that it gives +3 health to Puddle Stomper or Imp. Nope. Damn. Alright, well let's just take out Puddle Stomper and heal. So it's not the absolute worst. It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad. Alright, more small things. Taking down that Cabal Shadow Priest is gonna be tricky. Oh, nope, not taking it down. Not taking it down like ever. Alrighty. Not gonna happen. Alright, well, we'll just play Force Tank and heal. Might as well take out this 1-1. Force Tank, probably gonna take a Shadow of Death. I mean, we haven't had, or worse. The top deck, Mind Control.
My apologies.
Alright. Alright, well, I finally got a target for Shadow of Death. slams the brakes, I guess. 4-3. I probably need to heal my guy up to a 4-5. And I guess play Blood Mage Thalmas. It's not likely to be... Do I even have anything left for spell power? I don't think so. I think it was just... My two sweepers. Oh! A second Cabal Shadow Priest. I think I've lost this game. Want to play a fourth? A fourth minion? Nope. Okay. So I can't kill any of the 4/4s. I get an 8. I'm dead.
You have best.
Yep. Oh well. It happens. Alrighty, another priest.
The light shall bring victory.
So I think just the issue with my last game was just the sequencing of things. I might keep all of these. That I had sweepers early, and that was good. But I would have probably been better off just having dudes early and the sweepers later. Not much I can do about that. And then my opponent, double Cabal Shadow Priest and Mind Control, was a lot better than what I was running. So that's them's the bricks. We do what we can. Okay. What do we got?
For the crusade!
Pretty confident that I can tangle early here. Oh yeah. Straight off the top. Glorious. I can tangle with Shrinkmeister. Bomb Bomb is coming up on turn 5. Definitely happy having 3 Shadow Web Pains. It's just so good.
The damned stand ready.
Alrighty. So the 3/4, I can trick him to a 1/4 and hit it. I mean, then I can just play 2 guys.
Let us see if this will die, land lover.
It's probably fine. My opponent can just attack Blood Mage Thanos. I don't think it's really that great holding on to him until turn 7 to maybe have combos. Yeah, I just don't have stuff to go with Blood Mage Thanos. It was an optimistic pick, but it didn't pan out. And the Holy Spirit. No problem, Bob. Alright, so it goes up to 5. This is perfect, actually. That's perfect. Take him down, boys. Cool. Good hand. Upgraded Repair Bot and Harvest Golem, so I can drop those turn 8 if I feel. Cool. 3/3 comes down. Problem with Gnomish Inventor is I'm probably not going to be able to play another card, so I might just play Imp Master.
I am not a morning person.
I play Imp Master, then I can play Harvest Golem as well. What's the chances my Harvest Golem lives? Probably pretty high. I do have a 3/3 on the board. So my opponent can attack Harvest Golem and then heal the damage golem. Or you could just attack the 3/3, like, So if I lose Mectitude from this, I think that's still okay. My opponent's surely not going to be thinking about upgraded repair bots.
I wonder.
Temple Enforcer. Okay. He's big. He's large and or in charge. And take out the 3/3. Obviously. Yep. Really need a Shadow of Pain. We're gonna go with upgraded repair bot, repair however.
Available.
So 2-7. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can't quite take down the Orcanite Soulpriest. I probably just want to hit it once though. Hit it once and then attack face here and just heal my Harvest Golem. Cool. So Harvest Golem can get taken down. That's really not the point.
Your magic shall
all right, spell broken. That's 5-7. Okay, more stuff. Okay. That's okay, that's okay. Oh, max. Maximum. Well, I've got 8 mana. If my opponent has a Shadow Word of Death, you know what? We're still gonna do it, I think. And then we're just gonna take down all that I can. That is fine. That's fine, that's fine. So I'm behind on cards, but I do have a Gnomish Inventor. It's gonna help pull it back slightly. Chances of mind control tech stealing something? Not high. Oh really? No Shadow or Death? Well then. That's pretty good for me. You just assume that the priest player has always got Shadow or Death. But apparently not. Apparently not. Alrighty. It's all ogre now.
I can't do that.
Alright, we're playing two minions. It's gonna make Twilight Drake that a little bit worse. It'll be a 4-3. Eh. Oh well. I think I just want both out anyways.
Behold the might of
Stormwind. Alright, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. For me. Start with a Gnomish Inventor. Draw first. Oh, Thought Steal. That's bringing it back for the Twilight Drake. So let's steal it up. Okay, interesting. Let's heal. And yeah, just hit face. Let my opponent have a 1-2. Totally fine. Totally fine. So mind games. Not a great card, but hey, I mean I've thought soul in it, so it can't be horrible. Twilight Drake's gonna be a 4-5 when I play it next turn. Pretty good, pretty good. Okay, Shadow Form. Now things are getting interesting. So taking down Boulder Fist, right? Wait, what? Holy Nova, okay, alright. Makes a little more sense now. Okay, fine with it. My opponent's running out of cards. So this is all fine. We'll start with Twilight Drake. It'll be Twilight Drake. Mechanical Yeti is probably going to be better than whatever mind game spins up. So let's just go with that. And we'll leave the 1-1s on them.
Well, who are you?
So these 1-1s are going to take out 3-3s. So we'll just attack face here. We'll just attack face. One of them's going to attack in and then Mind Spike. So I might as well attack. Get that extra 3 before it dies. Okay. My game spins up. A 3-3! Okay. 4 mana 3-3. Not great. Not great value. Ooh, Darkhind Dwarf. Very good. Very good. So I'm gonna mind games Darkhind Dwarf. Shrinkmeister? Could shrink Temple Enforcer down to a 4. But it's not a huge difference. Probably still fine.
You call that a weapon.
Let us see if this works.
Much of a muchness, but it seems fine. take out this guy and take out a 3-3, I guess. Mind games or just heal my, you know, I gotta heal my Yeti. Gotta heal it. Smite. Alright, go. Alright. Feel like I'm in a commanding position here. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Alright, now that we've got absolute control of this game, now we can mind games, alright? Boys and girls, here we go. Here we go. Was it worth it? Yeah, 4 mana 3-2. This is why you don't run mind games. Alright. Heal and hit it. Alright, have some more heal. Keep him out of the mind spike range. So you can only take down 3-2, then I got 4-8, 12, 15. Not quite lethal.
Well played. Well played.
North Shire Cleric. Just gotta make sure I don't heal my own stuff.
Repairs available.
Before killing it. Alright, that's it. This one's done. Done like a dinner. A few subpar cards. I mean, I don't think Shadow Form is particularly great. It just turns off all of your pre-synergy. And mind games. Okay, we have fought valiantly against a bunch of control decks, but really my deck's more suited against aggro, so this should be pretty good. This should be pretty good. Upgraded repair, but, you know, I want to keep a 5 drop and all, but really I'm just going to play turn 2 Unstable Ghoul, turn 3 Imp Master, I guess maybe turn 4 Harvest Golem. Maybe I can keep upgraded repair, but, yeah, I mean it is a 5-5. Turn 2 Unstable Ghoul, turn 3 Imp Master. Or I could go turn 2 Unstable Ghoul, turn 3 Harvest Golem, turn 4 Upgraded Repair Bot. Alright. It's not the absolute worst. A turn 4 5-5 on its own is still fine. And if I do get to get the health on Harvest Golem, it's just so good. Otherwise, turn 4 Bomb Lobber is also pretty nice. Really? Nothing? Nothing at all. Alright. Unstable Ghoul is still fine. We'll soak up some damage at the very least.
This is going to be amazing.
Oh, or just straight up trade. Bomb Lobber! Turn to chicken. Well, at least a draw beast, I guess. I suppose that's still a thing. Yeah, let's just trade, I think. We'll trade. Play Harvest Golem. Harvest Golem is pretty safe for next turn. Get my upgraded repair bot values. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Forget you, Mechanical Yeti. I want my 2/7s. Alright. Yeah. And hey, a 5-5 versus a 4-5, it's a pretty good matchup. Next turn I got Bomb Lobber as well, so Bomb Lobber plus Harvest Golem is a better way to take down the 4-5. Oh, the Hound Master synergy. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. So we're going to start off with a Bomb Lobber. Well, I might just attack the 33 and then Bomb Lobber. Would I want Bomb Lobber to hit the 3-3? Not really.
Beatings available. Beatings available.
Alright, Bomb Lobber away. Cool. Alright, I'm happy with all of those things. That is all fine. So still got stuff on board versus a 4-5. Looking good. Deadly shot. Taking out the 3-3 is pretty good. Cool, cool, cool. That's fine, that's fine. Because it's all ogre now. So what am I worried about? More deadly shots? Not so much. Big stuff, I got Shadow with Dead. I feel like I've got this one. I feel like I've got this one. Alright, I got a good answer for Micro Machine in my Harvest Golem. 2-7's like 82-2's. So down to 3, probably want to get a bit of healing on my Boulder Fist, so let's just go with Mechanical Yeti and Earthen Ring Fireseer. Not fooling around with Imp Master or nothing like that, we just want get control of the board and hold it. Hold on! That's how we win. So, the beauty of Hunter in Arena, when you're playing against it, is just not even scared about Unleash the Hound combos, because they can't be that good. It can't be that good. Double kill command, that's pretty nasty. Pretty nasty. Ooh. But I am just gonna kill my opponent really quickly here. So, healing myself. We've gotta take down everything. Attack my opponent for 9. Let's play Tinker Town Tech just in case we get a damage. Oh, there we go, we did. So I'll play the damage and a Blood Celebrator, I guess. So my opponent has to kill 6. I mean, just use double kill command. Does my opponent have 4 damage? Oh, it does. Oh, wow. Wow. My opponent. The double kill command into Unleash. Jinxed myself pretty badly. Well, that was a little disappointing. A little disappointing to only hit 3. You know what? These games were good. Took a lot to take me down. That's for sure. Alright, didn't break even. Sad. Sad. Oh dear, only 4 packs, so we're working towards another 20 pack opening. Make sure you're posting in the comments, let me know what you want to see in the arena. Hey, I'm trying different things. Sometimes it goes well, and sometimes it only hits 3 wins, but whatever. We're learning together. So, thank you so much for sticking around, but until next time, bye.